3, 2, 1, boost ignition and liftoff of the Space Shuttle Discovery, returning to the space station, paving the way for future missions beyond.
In 1970, Sister Mary was surrounded by immense poverty in Africa. She saw children dying of hunger while people were celebrating the moon landing. So she wrote a letter to NASA asking how they could justify billions of dollars on space when so many children were starving on Earth. Her letter found its way to the desk of a top rocket scientist, and his response inspired this video. Sister Mary's perspective has come up time and time again, and it's totally understandable. Around the world, there is no shortage of human suffering. Poverty, disease, violence, hurricanes, wildfires. With all the suffering in the world, should public money still be invested in NASA? NASA's budget is currently $19.5 billion, and a 2011 survey found increased amounts of Americans don't think this is a good investment. However, the same survey showed that the majority of Americans believe it is essential for the US to be a world leader in space exploration. While $19.5 billion is a huge figure, as a percentage of the federal budget, it is the lowest proportion allocated to NASA in almost 60 years. In fact, for every $1 of federal spending, NASA receives just 0.4 of one penny, 0.4% of the budget. For comparison, military spending accounts for 16%, and interest payments on debt accounts for 6%. What value does NASA provide for their 0.4 of a penny? The challenges of space exploration require innovation and new technology. Many of these hard-won innovations spin off into technologies that solve problems here on Earth. Consider world hunger. It's essentially a problem of food production and food distribution. In some parts of the world, farms are highly efficient, using large-scale operations driven by technology. But in many areas, farms are relatively inefficient. Farms in the developing world could be used better if farmers had more effective methods of water control, fertilizer use, weather forecasting, fertility assessment, plantation programming, field selection, crop surveying, and so on. The best tool to provide all of this information are satellites. They can observe and measure many variables such as crop conditions, soil, droughts, rainfall, and so on. By making this information freely available to farmers, the harvest of food can be increased by giant proportions. NASA's AMSR-E satellite provides this information free of charge. It captures the global soil moisture and creates heat maps to show moisture levels. It is the most accurate way to estimate soil moisture, the main determinant of crop yield, which improves the forecast of how well food will grow. The US Department of Agriculture combines this information with weather trends to help empower regional and national officials to prepare and prevent food crises. Innovation for NASA has also led to an array of spin-off technologies that you use. In the last week, have you used memory foam or baby formula? Have you drunk an electrolyte sports drink? Does your home use a smoke detector? Have you ever flown on a plane that didn't ice up and crash? What about taking a photograph on your phone? The innovation behind all of this technology was driven by NASA. The insulation in your home that keeps you cool in summer and warm in winter was developed by NASA. The heat and flame-resistant clothing that firefighters use was also developed by NASA. WBHRZS, a powerful coder with a terrible name, was also developed by NASA. It chemically bonds with steel to protect it from corrosion, and it's used in everything to coat bridge girders, pipelines, oil rigs, military tanks, dock equipment, buoys, water facilities, power stations, antennas, tractor frames, and machine products, just to name a few. It was even used on the Statue of Liberty during a refurbishment. And these spin-off examples don't even scratch the surface. NASA has recorded over 1,700 different technology spin-offs. Studies estimate that for every $1 invested in NASA, the economy is boosted by $7 to $14. That means that with NASA's current budget of $19.5 billion, the US economy can expect an injection from anywhere from $137 to $273 billion. That's much stronger than the average return from shares or bonds or real estate. This is the first view with human eyes of Earth rising over the limb of the moon. It was taken from Apollo 8 in 1968. It shows just how limited our Earth is, how we are just a precious island in an unlimited void. The value provided by NASA is not limited to inventions or financial return. NASA's work crosses borders and improves international relationships. The International Space Station is a great example of this. The space station is a joint project from the American, Canadian, European, Japanese, and Russian space agencies. At $150 billion, it is the most expensive single item ever constructed, and it has been continually occupied for over 17 years. It serves as a microgravity and space environment research lab, with crew members conducting experiments in biology, physics, astronomy, meteorology, and other fields. Men and women from 18 different countries have visited the station. International cooperation in space is not limited to the International Space Station. While the Russian-American relationship has been tense following the Trump election, this tension does not extend to the space agencies. In September 2017, Russia and the United States agreed to cooperate on a NASA-led program to build the first lunar space station, part of a long-term plan to send humans to Mars. The challenges of space are simply too big for a single country to continuously push on alone. Space exploration breaks down borders. It doesn't care about age or race or gender or color. By pushing further into space, we build unity and strength here on Earth, which in turn helps to challenge the greed, misunderstanding, and selfish ambition that is behind so many of our challenges.
We wish that every human being could see with their eyes, not just pictures, but with their own eyes, what the Earth looked like from space. And I personally think it would change us as a species. It would change us and make us all realize that Earth is really a spaceship, and we're living on a spaceship with just a thin shell that keeps us safe from the vacuum and darkness of space.
Whilst unity and improved international relations can go a long way to reducing inequality and other global issues, it doesn't guarantee our survival as a species. While Earth is the only home we have ever known, history teaches us that survival on a single dot of dirt and water in the large vacuum of space is perilous. Just ask the dinosaurs. Colonizing other planets avoids the beware of all your eggs in one basket and drastically increases our chances of survival as a species. The more planets we occupy, the less likely a single event could wipe out all of us. Mars is the ideal planet for us. It has a similar length of days as Earth and has water ice on the surface. Building upon the shoulders of NASA's work, there are private groups such as Mars One and SpaceX aiming to establish human settlements on Mars. Perhaps it's reasonable to suggest that these private groups should take control of space exploration with their own funds, rather than NASA using the federal budget. The problem with privatizing this sector is that these companies, by their very nature, are focused on what will provide the highest return. This includes activities such as asteroid mining, satellite launching, and space tourism. Interesting activities to be sure, but focused on profit. On the other hand, NASA has projects like the DART mission. DART is a planetary defense mission which aims to deliberately crash a spacecraft, moving at almost 4 miles per second into an asteroid to change its direction. Essentially, the Armageddon movie without the drilling team. NASA has dedicated resources to track asteroids and develop approaches to stop Armageddon-level impacts. This is something that no private company focuses on. Beyond these very pragmatic reasons, there's another purpose to continue to invest in NASA. To inspire dreamers. Jim Adams, a retired NASA executive, said, "Humans are constantly asking what's beyond the horizon. Our imagination takes us there. If we begin to imagine this, it will happen. It is written into our DNA to ask what is next." Of space travel, Elon Musk says, "It is important to have a future that is inspiring and appealing. There has to be a reason you get up in the morning and you want to live. What do you love about the future? If the future doesn't include being out there amongst the stars and becoming a multi-planet species, I find that incredibly depressing." Mark Rober, a former NASA engineer and now a major YouTuber, said, "We send men to the moon orbiters to Saturn and rovers to Mars. Not necessarily because there's some financial incentive or some quick payoff that we are looking to exploit, but because as humans, there are fundamental burning questions we yearn to answer. Exploring the unknown and breaking boundaries that we once thought were impossible drives innovation and flames the fire of curiosity inside all of us. So for less than half a penny on the dollar, NASA provides strong financial return with spin-off technologies that make your life better. They develop innovations that improve the quality of life for millions of people around the world. They help to break down international borders and build unity. They develop programs that could save our entire species from extinction. And they inspire wonder inside of us. Just imagine what they could do with a whole penny. When Sister Mary got the response to her letter, she wrote back to NASA, saying, "Thank you. From now on, I firmly believe in the profound value of the space program." What do you think? Is NASA worth it? Should their budget change? Do you agree with the points I've raised? Let me know your thoughts below. This has been Alex from Lifelong Learners. Embrace curiosity.